Under Connacht's leadership, the clansmen of Gower had pushed the Mykridia back into their dark swamps. As word of this great deed spread across the land, it reached even the great city of Llancarfan. The Emperor Leitrim himself dispatched a contingent of Royal Heron Guard to find this barbarian savior and bid him audience. It was the Emperor's champion Damas who convinced Connacht to travel with him to Llancarfan to aid in their battle with a common enemy. The Emperor's fears were justified. Moagim, the faceless terror, had once again been reborn to this world. During the Age of Splendor, Moagim was the most powerful and wicked archmage in all the world. His insatiable lust for power brought war between the nations of humanity and his armies of undying. Even with his great powers, Moagim's army was defeated, his body being drawn and quartered. Yet even in his death, he was still triumphant. His curse brought forth the Mykridia into the world, leading to the downfall of civilization and the end of the Age of Reason. A millennia of darkness later, Moagim had returned to wage war on the lands of humanity once again. The Avatara of Llancarfan were unsure if this new threat was indeed Moagim reborn or just an imposter using his name. Some began calling Moagim the Leveler, a name that was understood by a very few at the time. Those that did know the true meaning of the term shuddered at the very thought. Traveling through the forested hills of Talwin, the contingent of Heron Guard escorted Connacht on their long journey towards the city of Llancarfan. During the evenings around the campfires, Damas would attempt to convey to Connacht the importance of his imperial summons. Connacht was always silent and dismissive, unimpressed by imperial titles or decrees. Damas became frustrated with the barbarians' less than civil attitudes and demeanor. During one night, a distant wolf howled its worship of the moon, and to the guardsman's surprise, Connacht answered the baying with a howl of his own. Incredulous, Damas stared at the wild man, doubting his sanity. Connacht, grinning a feral smile, only laughed at the astonished guardsman and laid down to sleep. A day later, not wishing to walk alongside a madman such as Connacht, Damas and a group of guardsmen scouted ahead of the contingent. The rain of the early day had stopped and the sun shined brightly on the forest. Strangely, there were no sounds of birds or animals that morning.
You fight like a wolf.
No time to speak. More devils approach.
take you all on. Hope you guys don't fight as bad as you smell. My mother could beat you.
Thank you.
Hope you guys don't fight as bad as you smell.
Casualties. Casualty. Casualties. Casualty. 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 Casualty.
The nation of Gower blamed the Koth Bruig for Connacht's death and never forgave them for the tragedy. War between the two nations was not far behind.
Fight like a wolf.
No time to speak. More devils approach.
Thank you.
Stand clear! Stand clear!
Emperor!
Fire could beat you.
Aside. hide!
Escaping from the ambush, Connacht led the retinue southwards towards Llancarfan. Damas, having witnessed Connacht's battle prowess and been saved from death by the man, swore his friendship and loyalty to the Wolf from Gower.